been in my DM said I'm handsome. This girl been in my DM said I'm handsome. And we all reach, that's just how I feel. He's the last one out to get this dough. No way, love one of you bucket headed hoes. No way, hit the streets and we break the code. No way, get the. Let me show you because I feel like this is gonna blow your mind.
A genius. Have you seen this my genius?
Just can't date a dude with a badge. When we fell in love,
I fell in love with a gangster, like, so he put my name in the top. Damn. But I don't let him come to the crib, so we get it on where we at.
Okay guys, listen up, he's like a bro, he's just like any other bro. It's just, he became a bro later than we did, you know? Like, he had to take some bro juice, and then he got really hungry and tired, and his voice got deep, you know, all the bro stuff. He just had to go to the doctor's office to get the bro juice to start the bro-man. He's just like the rest of us, he just might be a little less stinky, but I don't know.
So, good morning. How are you doing, Lou?
When did we start?
Do you know what time it is?
No.
Do you have any idea?
No.
It's 5:00 in the evening. Actually, it's 5:15.
That's so funny.
And you had your surgery at about 1:30 today. So you've been here?
Yeah, I definitely feel...
quite a while. What are you feeling now?
I mean, I don't know.
What do you feel? Did you dream?
I don't know.
You didn't have any dreams?
I don't even remember starting.
You don't remember what?
Starting.
Really? Do you remember counting backwards at all?
No, I don't remember anything.
Do you remember the last thing you... what was the last thing you remember?
Being... in the room?
In the operating room?
No, like not even that.
Like right here in this room? Do you remember seeing Papa last or me last?
Papa.
Papa, yeah.
You were here?
No, I wasn't. You're right. Oh. I had to wait in the waiting room. But I got to see you in recovery first.
My throat is so sore.
Yeah, they said, you know why your throat hurts? You know why?
Oh, wait a minute.
What?
I don't know.
How many?
20.
Start lower. I beg
you.
Izzy. And my last name Blitz, so I'm picking a tool up. My stepper gon' brush him if I press the button. Too drippy to scuffle. Drippy to scuffle. The blick in the duffel with tang with a muzzle, so why would I touch?
Yo, this is like kind of something I had to like learn throughout my transition. So I'm a transgender man. I've been in my transition for almost, I'm coming up on 4 years, like in a couple weeks now. But obviously, like if someone meets me right off the bat, if I meet someone new, I don't think they're gonna be able to tell that I'm trans, honestly. That's just my opinion. I think I passed pretty well. So I am trans. A lot of people think I'm lying for some reason. I got top surgery here, went through a hysterectomy, and I literally don't have a dick right now. I'm getting bottom surgery next year of October. But when I meet new people, obviously, if I want to be friends with them, I kind of want them to get to know me and who I am as a person. So obviously, I need to share when I'm trans. And I got to figure out when the right time is to share that. It's a little different with guy friends compared to girls. Girls, I'm just a lot more comfortable with. The boys, I don't know how they're going to react, so I kind of read the situation. I'm good at reading people. But honestly, when I tell people, they kind of have positive reactions. They're very supportive. So once I'm comfortable, I just say it.
I'm Noah, and this is my voice, Preeti.
I am Noah, and this is my voice, 1 month on T.
Hi, I'm Noah, and this is my voice, 2 months on T.
Hi, I'm Noah, and this is my voice, 3 months on T.
Hi, I'm Noah, and this is my voice, 4 months on T.
Hi, my name's Noah, and this is my voice, 5 months on T.
Hi, my name's Noah, and this is my voice, 6 months on T.
Hi, my name is Noah, and this is my voice, 7 months on T.
Hi, I'm Noah, and this is my voice, 8 months on T.
Hi, my name is Noah, and this is my voice, 9 and 10 months on T. I forgot to record last month.
Hi, I'm Noah, and this is my voice, 11 months on T.
Hi, my name is Noah, and this is my voice, 1 year on T.
Hi, my name is Noah, and this is my voice, 2 years on T.
Hi, my name is Noah, and this is my voice, 3 years on T.
Hi, my name is Noah, and this is my voice, 4 years on T.
Oh my god, you're just my type. How are you still single?
Transgender, probably autistic, never had a real job, would probably cry if he touched a wooden spoon, literally has a fully grown adult man nonce walking around with a tattoo of me on his leg as a child. IBS.
Oh my god.
I don't wanna cry anymore. I wanna feel alive, I don't even wanna die anymore.
What's your pronouns?
I'm a male. I'm a man. I'm a he. I don't get into that mentally ill stuff.
I love straight men. They're so funny. I was talking to this dude and he was like, wait, so you're like a trans man, right? I'm like, yeah. He's like, so you don't have like a wiener? I'm like, no. He's like, but you said that you're a verse. How do you top if you don't? And I was like, come on now.
What fudgy way?
In the cut with my twin, we be vibing. Classy bitch, but they know I be.
Where are your titties?
Trans Guy Moments Part 12. I had a job interview the other day and the woman was like, I think Luca is a really nice name. My son is also called Lucas, by the way. And I was so close to saying, thank you, I actually picked it myself. Ah, so tempting, but yeah, I didn't, obviously.
Fucking smokes, dude. My cut is insane. Shout out to my barber, dog.
That's because I'm testosterone deficient. Cause I was born a chick.
Me a gun, and I'ma come back here and set this motherfucker off.
Take a name out of your mouth, you don't deserve to.
You just triggered my fight or flight response, and I am a flightless bird.
I just got done painting my nails, look. I'm very proud of myself.
Oh my god, guys, I just got done painting my nails, look.
I'm sorry, what? Why the fuck do you sound like that? Oh my god.
Treat a car like you treat a woman.
Go on.
No.
Hi, my name is Ains. I use he, him pronouns, and this is my first day on testosterone. Today is my fourth week on T.
So even though I'm like 7.5 weeks on T,
it's been 11 weeks on T.
And this is my fourth month on testosterone.
I'm gonna make a video of my T-shot routine.
So I am 24 weeks on T.
I have two things to say about testosterone right now. And for reference, I'm about to be 9 months on testosterone.
Hey, it has now been 10 months on testosterone, and this is my voice. I'm also going to talk a little bit about the most recent changes that I've experienced. Things that I feel like wait until a little bit later, like close to your 1 year mark, or at least that's how it's happened for me. So I've been getting a lot of like cystic acne, especially around here right now. And it has more to do with like ingrown, they're more ingrown hairs than it is cystic acne, because like my facial hair is like starting to come in. So like around my mustache and my beard, I've been getting cystic acne. My hair had slowly gotten curlier, but in the last like month it's like really ramped up and gotten a lot curlier. Like I have like ringlets in the back and stuff like that, so that's really fun. My body hair has gotten significantly darker in the last month, which is like absolutely crazy. And my favorite thing is that my voice has like settled a bit, so like I can sing more and my voice doesn't crack as much. When I get excited, my voice doesn't crack. But yeah, those are all of my exciting tea updates. Have a wonderful day.
Oh, rock on, freaky bro. Yeah.
I wanted to be a woman. I wanted to be a man. I wanted to be the one that you could understand. I wanted to be the one to hear my pain. Broken down the line.
And it was all.
Transphobia is actually crazy as fuck.
My freshman year of high school, we had gym the last period of the day, and there was a guy, and he was cool as fuck, but he used to identify as a girl. So he was trans. The locker room was fucking hell. And I don't want to hear no shit like, oh, you've just never been in a locker room. I've been in a locker room. That shit was crazy. Motherfuckers would walk around with their meats out talking about, oh my god, this shit natural as fuck. Just all types of shit to try to get in that person's head. And he was really cool, like, he kept to himself, but like, if you had a conversation with him, you'd realize he's unproblematic as fuck. He just wanted to be himself. And don't get me started on when we'd actually do fucking physical activities. We play kickball, everybody be on their phones, not paying attention, until the transgender guy would go up and kick. Now everybody looking like Game 7 Braun, staring that motherfucker down, ready to... And they wouldn't even catch the ball. They'd wait till it hit the ground so they could pick it up and throw it at him full speed. So if you ever see trans people advocating for rights, they're actually treated like shit in society.
Welcome to another episode of The Ty Rant.
Hi, I'm Ty.
This is a series where I let myself go off on things that really grind my gears from the comfort of my Honda Civic where no one can hear my screams. Today we'll be talking about TERFs, or as I like to call them, transphobes. Those of you who don't know, TERF stands for Trans-Exclusionary Radical Feminists. These are self-proclaimed feminists who do not include trans women in their feminism. However, if your feminism is not intersectional, then it is not feminism. Alok shares their brilliant perspective on this on Laverne Cox's podcast, and if you haven't listened to it, check it out on my link tree. They point out that the minimization of womanhood to a woman's ability to reproduce is the root of all misogyny. This is the core belief that created the societal standard that a woman should stay at home. Trans women are living proof that womanhood extends far beyond that. Womanhood is a powerful quality of spirit. The notion that only women who can give birth are worthy of womanhood is point blank transphobic and misogynistic. And what about all the cis women who can't give birth? Are they not women? Why are you going after them, Professor Umbridge? These trans exclusionary radical transphobes have become the voice of their oppressor. Make it stop! See you next time! Welcome to
I was just reminded that transphobic people will be transphobic by telling trans people that when archaeologists look at their bones, they'll know what their biological sex was. And no, they won't. If I've learned anything as an anthropology student, it's that finding out things about the past is never easy. But unless you're referring to historical archaeology, which you're probably not, because archaeology is moving away from unethically disturbing burials. And historical archaeology is recent enough that graves wouldn't have deteriorated, meaning you can tell when it's a burial. Meaning that the bodies that we're actually looking at don't have a lot of genetic material left. Of course, in the right conditions, you can still find DNA. But even then, this is situational, and there's no guarantee that the DNA that you do find will be completely intact or preserved. Because of all this, what we usually do is we sex a skeleton. This means that we look at the skeleton and observe its features in order to tell what sex it was. But that's not 100% accurate. You see, with human skeletons, it's hard to tell because even with our sexual dimorphism, it is not a constant or strict dimorphism. That just means just because guys are normally bigger than girls, that doesn't mean that they always are. And even then, we're very regional. For example, the average height in Japan is not the same as the average height in the United States. And even then, when we sex a skeleton, we are not just looking at the skeleton, we're looking at the burial, the things they were buried with, the material culture surrounding them, context clues. Without context, you do not have archaeology. If the context of your burial was gendered, we're gonna assume that you aligned with the gender of the burial, as long as we know enough about your culture's burial practices. And that's not even considering not everybody wants an in-ground burial. And given the way our planet is going, we don't know if we'll be around long enough for there to be archaeologists to find our bodies. So stop using science to justify and support your just blatant disregard for other human lives.